Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The Japanese government also launched an attack against Malaya. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Hong Kong. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Guam. Last night, Japanese forces attacked the Philippine Islands. Last night, the Japanese attacked Wake Island. And this morning, the Japanese attacked Midway Island.
In the first 4 months of the war with Japan, Singapore and the Dutch East Indies had fallen. Darwin was heavily bombed on February the 19th, 1942, by the same carrier group that had attacked Pearl Harbor. As early as March 1942, Japanese forces landed at Leh and Salamoa on the northern New Guinea coast. Port Moresby became a key objective for the Japanese. This epic battle between aircraft carriers was fought off the Queensland coast from the 4th to the 8th of May, 1942. Australia rightly feared a Japanese invasion, and the nation was fully mobilized.
My Lord Mayor, men and women of Australia, for I'm speaking now to everybody in this Commonwealth, wherever he or she may be. The full cabinet today directed the War Cabinet to gazette the necessary regulations for the complete mobilization and the complete ordering of all the resources, human and material, in this Commonwealth for the defense of this Commonwealth. That means clearly and specifically that every human being in this country is now, whether he or she likes it, at the service of the government to work in the defense of Australia.
On the 21st of July 1942, an advanced reconnaissance party of the Nankaishitai South Seas Detachment landed on the north coast of New Guinea without opposition. This elite unit, under the command of General Horiai, soon received orders from Tokyo to begin the advance over the rugged Owen Stanley Range. The Japanese moved quickly inland and encountered their first opposition the following night when a 40-strong unit of the Papuan Infantry Battalion staged an ambush near Gona. A number of fierce engagements took place during the following days, when forward elements of the 39th Militia Battalion and members of the Papuan Infantry Battalion attempted to hold a numerically superior and better equipped Japanese force. Along the coast at Buna, 12 Anglican missionaries were executed. Most were beheaded by the Japanese or murdered by local collaborators. A sculpture of Papuan teacher Lucian Tapiti features among 20th century martyrs on the Great West Door of Westminster Abbey in London. The loss of the strategically vital Kokoda airfield on July the 29th was a severe blow to the Australian forces. Resupply became extremely difficult. Kokoda village was lost and then regained by the Australians, and then lost again. During these fierce engagements, the defenders made good use of the Kokoda plateau as a strategic position, the Japanese suffering many casualties. Lieutenant Colonel Tsukamoto leading his men to attack Kokoda village and airfield. He was the only Japanese battalion commander to have fought the entire campaign. Lieutenant Colonel William Owen, the commanding 39th Battalion officer, lost his life on the lip of the Kokoda plateau. The loss of this highly regarded leader was a further blow for the defenders. Captain Templeton was a father figure to the young 39th Battalion troops. He too lost his life and his body was never found. Some reports suggest that he was wounded and gave his interrogators false information before being executed. However, the circumstances of his death remain unknown. At the age of 60, Doc Vernon, a decorated World War I veteran, crossed the Owen Stanleys in July 1942 to, as he put it, make himself useful. "There is no medical officer with those 39th youngsters," he said. He tended wounded and dying soldiers during the campaign, and his own grave's epitaph fittingly reads, "A friend to all men." With the retreat from Kokoda, the fighting moved into the rugged Owen Stanley Range. The unforgiving tropical terrain represented an awful place in which to fight a war. The jungle with its confusing matrix of light and shade was ideal for ambush, and the Australians made good use of defensive tactics during the retreat phase of the battle. By mid-September, the Japanese reached Irrawaddy. It was as far as they would ever advance. The Australians held the opposing positions on Nimitta Ridge. It was the last defensive high ground before Port Moresby. Between the 25th of August and the 7th of September, another Japanese invasion force was defeated at Milne Bay. Field Marshal Viscount William Slim remarked that it was the Australian soldiers who first broke the spell of invincibility of the Japanese army. Those of us in Burma have cause to remember. Royal Australian Air Force Kitty Hawk fighters played an important role at Milne Bay. Having reached their limit on the Kokoda Track, and suffering reversals fighting the Americans in the Solomon Islands, on the 18th of September, 1942, the Japanese were ordered to withdraw back across the Owen Stanley Range to the north coast. After fighting many intense battles against the retreating Japanese, elements of the Australian Army entered, unopposed, Kokoda Village on November 2, 1942. On the afternoon of the following day, Major General George Vasey, commander of the Australian forces on the Kokoda Track, led a flag-raising ceremony on the plateau. A brand new nylon weave Australian flag had been airdropped earlier by an American fighter pilot for the ceremony.